All right, up next is Road Rash 64. Yeah, has nothing to do with Thanksgiving. I just want to play it since it will be short and easy. RO. Black cartridge. Unlike the usual gray. Copyright. RO. Paint splotch. Now this game I didn't rent back when it came out. Right, before we get to that. I got this with the manual for $21.99 back in 2018. Yeah, I remember seeing ads for this in the gaming magazines. Didn't look too good. The graphics sucked. But I can see why the graphics aren't as good. Because it has over 10 racers on screen at one time and plus the other vehicles. So, they weren't as high definition or good, high quality, because to keep the frame rate up. Yeah, don't make the graphics so good, so you'll it's not taxing on the processing power of the CPU. Yep. Yeah, that's the first time I played this is in 2018. Now I played the first time I played the series was the third game, back in like the mid 90s. My friend had it. I thought that was funny as hell, being able to beat the shit out of the other racers. There's some games I wish you could do that. Yep, that's the unique thing about this one. Oh, and here's a legal disclaimer about that. And now this one takes place in one big open world, although its tracks aren't, you don't have to go all around, it's track based. But if you want to screw around, you can drive all over the whole island. But that's too bad there wasn't a free drive mode. You always have to play one of the races. I've got multiplayer on this one. Big game, that's the main game. I think you gotta go through, 38 races? And then you beat the game. Now, unlike a lot of races where you have to get first place, you just have to qualify by being in the top three. Although it's better to get first place, so you get more money to get better bikes. I'm gonna get weapons here. Soundtrack of licensed music, although it doesn't have a Soundgarden's rusty cage like in the original one for the 3DO, PlayStation 1, and Saturn. Yeah, I was watching videos of the other Road Rash games, and I was watching Classic Game Room's review, and then I heard, and I just remembered that it was Dean from Escape the Game and sent the PlayStation 1 version in. Boy, did Classic Game Room go downhill, that channel. Nope, that's pretty much it. I'll see you guys on the live stream,